Hi, I'm Ken Johnson, Executive Dean of the Heritage College, and I'm here today with my good friend, Andy Yuan, who is a 1987 graduate of the Heritage College. Welcome here today, Andy.
Thank you, Ken.
So tell me, what got you interested in medicine to start off with?
I think the desire to help people, compassion, and also it's noble career and noble understanding who I am. And with that as the background, being Asian also it helps because it's really something that really expand your personal growth as well as your ability to deal and help people is the main reason I went.
Oh, awesome. So tell me, how did you find what was then the Ohio University College of Osteopathic Medicine, or how did we find you?
I think the concept was that I want to go to a medical school. I was fortunate to be admitted both in a MD and a DO school, but I always like a challenge. And OU put me on a wait list the first year. So I need to overcome obstacle. As you can see physically, I overcome a lot. So emotionally, I said, maybe I want to do something that's never been done before. Treating with a disability, at the same time, learn about myself through the process.
Right. So tell me a little bit about your journey after this and what your practice is like here now.
The journey was much the same, discovering my own strength and weaknesses and overcome them. And then the journey was basically transferring to a subspecialty practice of physical medicine rehab, which is helping people with disability and how to help them overcome not just the physical, but the emotional, the psychological. And as they watch you treat, say, what's he doing? How's he doing it? I said, you know, it's like, you know, convergence and evolution. Because of the disability, I become much more sensory, hypersensitized. Mm-hmm. I feel things that, like, you know, musicians who are blind can play. You develop a sixth sense, and that sense is something that every human being believes in. And if you're able to open their heart and soul, you connect that, and it leads to greater and better things.
Right. Well, we had the privilege of having you spend some time in this lab with our faculty and our students. It was really awesome, by the way. What advice would you give our current students as they are walking on their journey for osteopathic medicine?
I think it'd be very simple. Take this honorable, noble trade that you're learning. Be confident that you are better than you realize. And the trades and the skills that you learn will take you through a lifetime learning in such a way that will reward you, both long-term and short-term. You will overcome. You have the best education in the world.
Yeah. Well, you know, I often say that I feel blessed to have had the best faculty, staff, and students in the nation by far. And there's another category, which is alumni. And I think you are a truly shining star in our profession. And we are just so proud of everything that you've done and have really enjoyed having you come home again.